roads, there have to be traffic lights, there have to be whatever. But before the first people move in, you're really going to have to think cheaper.
This is a failure. I think it's a tremendous asset. It's a very high-level achievement. They're coming from top, top, top achievers. And the level is a very, very high level. And yet, the impression I got is that there's definitely a warm, caring atmosphere.
And the Baruch Ber says, because how do we expect our daughters to marry Bnei Torah if they don't see the boys dancing on Simchas Torah? We see a matzav of Simchas Torah that automatically affects us and affects our families. And that's the point which the Rebbe always expressed to me. But nothing can match the intensity of Yeshiva Gedolah.
Rubinstein מוצא את עצמו להקים ישיבה שזה כמו מרכז, שיהיה מרכז תורני בשכונה, שיש איזו השפעה סביבתית. אז כמובן שמי שיכול חייב וצריך לעזור לו, זה אינטרס שלנו. והישיבה שלו, אם יוצא השם, תהיה הכתר של השכונה, התרה של השכונה. שלימודים של בן תורה זה הכתר הכי יפה שיכול להיות. אין כתר יותר יפה מאשר לבין לימודים של בן תורה.
כל רגע ורגע של תורה של הקדוש ברוך הוא, זה דבר, זה עוצמה נוראה. יש לו את הכוח, הוא עושה כל דבר, כל רגע ורגע נחז רוח לקדוש ברוך
הוא. The administration of yeshiva is very similar to any other establishment that offers full board and lodging and education and special events. The main difference, though, between a yeshiva and other such establishments is that your main income stream does not come from your student body or from the people that you are accommodating and entertaining. The cost would be prohibitively high and may exclude some of our top students. Rather, it comes from donors who enter into a socher zvulun relationship where they get to benefit from the fruits of Torah, the brocha, the tremendous brocha of Torah, through the donation. So we'd like to invite you to join in with our success story and to become one of our generous supporters.